I hate salads. What should I do? People seem to think that when they make a switch to the plant paradox, they seem to believe that they're stuck eating salads for the rest of their life. And I want to be the first one to tell you that's not true. In fact, you never have to eat a salad in your life, unless you want to, of course. Yes, I know I'm the guy with a breakfast salad recipe in his book, so maybe this sounds especially crazy coming from me. But if you're someone who hates salads, or if you're just over it and want something else, I'm here to tell you that's okay. Nowhere in the rule book, or the cookbook for that matter, does it say that you're required to eat salads. That said, you are required, or at least incredibly, ridiculously, highly encouraged to eat your veggies, and to eat them with plenty of olive oil. So, for a lot of people, salads are simply the easiest option. But if you're not a raw veggie person, or of the thought of another salad makes you roll your eyes in boredom, let's talk about a few other ways you can actually enjoy plenty of veggies and olive oil too without eating a single salad. First, I want to talk soup, because you can make a soup with just about anything and you don't need a recipe. You just saute the veggies of your choice in some olive oil. I suggest starting with a base of garlic, onions, and celery, then adding in the veggies of your choice. Things like leafy greens, broccoli, cauliflower, sweet potatoes, or mushrooms. Then saute them until tender, throw in some broth, homemade of course if possible, and simmer until good and flavorful. You can eat a soup like that, or go ahead and puree it with a little coconut milk if you prefer, something a bit creamier. Totally your call. But no matter how you eat it, you're getting a mouthful of vegetables and a bit of olive oil in every delicious body-warming bite. Now, I understand you can't eat soup for every meal. Some meals call for something heartier. And one of my favorite ways to enjoy a ton of veggies and plenty of healthy fats is to whip up a quick batch of fried rice. Yep, you heard me right, fried rice. I just use cauliflower rice instead of regular rice. And I stir fry it with oil, fresh ginger and garlic, some onions, mushrooms, greens, an omega-3 egg, and a hearty dash of coconut aminos. It's a quick, easy meal that'll remind you of much of the Chinese takeout that you won't even remember you're eating a giant bowl full of veggies. But maybe Asian food isn't your thing. Well, another incredibly simple way to enjoy plenty of veggies is to roast them. Because if you do it well, you can make them actually taste kind of like junk food, especially things like okra, cauliflower, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and mushrooms, which are really good at taking on the flavors of things around them. I like to toss them in tons of olive oil, garlic, and rosemary, and then roast them in a pan at 425 degrees oven until the edges are actually crispy and brown, and they're incredibly fragrant and tender. If you let them get a little extra crispy, like I like to do, they almost feel like fries when you bite into them, especially okra and cauliflower. I can't get my okra fries from the oven to the dinner table because the family has devoured them before they arrive. Now, another solid way to sneak more vegetables into your life without making a single salad is to puree your vegetables and mix the puree into just about anything you eat. I'm talking about a spinach puree folded into guacamole, plant paradox brownies with pureed cauliflower in them. I know it sounds weird, but it actually works. And of course, the classic smoothies. Now, by now you know, your typical fruit smoothie is out of the plan. But take some romaine lettuce and mint, a little lemon juice, an orange zest, some ginger and some stevia, and blend it up with an avocado and some water or coconut milk, and you've got yourself a super delicious smoothie. Drink it for breakfast and you're enjoying your greens first thing before you knew what hit you. Not bad. Now, before I go, I want to share one other recipe, and I'll warn you right away, this is a salad. But I like to call it the salad haters salad, because every single person I know loves it, even if they avoid salad like the plague. To make it, all you have to do is take a bunch of really finely shredded firm greens, like Brussels sprouts, cabbage, radicchio, or even kale. Put them in a bowl with salt and lemon juice, then massage the greens until tender. Next, toss them with olive oil, some pecorino cheese, toasted walnuts, fresh parsley, and if you'd like, maybe some thinly sliced prosciutto. That's it. You're done. And believe me, even if you hate salads, this one will have you coming back for seconds or even thirds. It's that good. Just remember, I didn't come up with the plant paradox to make you feel restricted or deprived, or like you're stuck eating salads until you die. There's absolutely nothing you're required to eat. So the next time you're sick of salads, make one of these dishes instead. I think you'll agree, they're as delicious as they are simple. And your gut will thank you. Because I'm Dr. Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you and a bowl of soup.